We've been on a hot streak here in Central Florida when it comes to the weather, but with all streaks, they do come to an end.
I tell you what, we need to put the end to the fog, and I think we're going to do that tomorrow morning, guys. Let me go ahead and show you what it looks like out there right now. Not bad at all. We do have some clouds out there, and that's going to be our saving grace as we take you through the overnight time frame. We've got this big disturbance in the Gulf. It's creating clouds. When you don't have clouds, you get fog. Let me show you the picture this morning from Joe Adalia, one of our very own, who was flying out to the Vegas area today, this morning, right around 8 o'clock. Look at the fog now. This is Orlando proper. Plenty of fog just to the east of it and to the west of it over here. We had relatively clear skies overnight, but that's going to change now. As we get you through the overnight time frame, we've got a developing area of low pressure now coming out of East Texas. A lot of moisture with it and plenty of clouds. These clouds will ride towards the east and from time to time swing overhead across Central Florida. Anytime you have clouds overhead at night, it limits the amount of fog. I don't think we're going to be fog free, but I don't think we're going to see that locally dense fog widespread like we had this morning. 70 Daytona Beach, 74 Leesburg, 75 in Orlando. Winds are kind of chaotic to light as you work your way up towards the villages and up towards Ocala. So fog settling in well after midnight, 5, 6, 7 o'clock in the morning, but not as dense as what we saw out there this morning. A daybreak temperature coming in at about 56 degrees. Overnight low temperatures look like this: 51 Ocala, 53 the villages, 54 in beautiful Mount Dora. We take you on into Orlando, 56 there over towards Oviedo, Longwood, 55, 56 degrees should about do it. Towards the coast, not a big change here either. 55 New Smyrna Beach, 57 Palm Bay, and 52 degrees for our friends up there in beautiful Bonnell. And over towards Flagler Beach coming in at about 54 degrees. So big dome of high pressure off to our east, a light south-southwest flow tomorrow. That means the afternoon highs again running 75 to about 80 degrees. Remember now, average high temperatures for this time of year typically run right around 71. Now, this is one computer model that's going a little bit more aggressive now with rainfall tomorrow. It's about to update itself, but from the early afternoon run, 1 to 2 inches of rain across a good chunk of the northern peninsula of Central Florida. Not all the computer models are in that camp. I'm going to show you a different scenario coming up at about 547. But note the afternoon highs tomorrow. Very comfortable. 74 to about 79 degrees. Average high temperature typically runs right around 71. So watching some fog in the morning tomorrow, but not that bad. Noontime 72. 5 o'clock temperature 75. In between downtown Orlando over towards Executive Airport could touch 79, maybe even 80. Front arrives on Wednesday. A few showers and storms. We are not, let me make that clear, we are not worried about severe weather. Noticeably cooler and less humid there on Friday and Saturday, but we crank up the humidity and the warmer temperatures Sunday on into Monday with another storm system. More on that coming up at 6, guys. Back to you.